to Salem, North Carolina in 1785. I'm Sister Pauline, and this is Sister Emily.
We're here in the Mitch Garden to talk about life cycles. A life cycle refers to a living organism's development from birth to death.
Yes, the garden is the perfect place to study life cycles, where all the organisms work together to help each other grow and just meet each other's needs.
Before we start talking about life cycles, I'd like to talk a little bit about the gardens here in Salem. Salem is not a farming community, it is a town, but the gardens of families in Salem function like our future friends' grocery stores. If we want to eat something, we have to grow it.
Actually, some of the families that were here in Salem, their families came from Europe. And so a lot of the things here were grown in Europe. Plus, there were people that were brought here from Africa and the Caribbean. So we have plants that they were growing. So we have a very interesting mix of plants here.
One of our Moravian brothers, Christian Reuter, he actually came from Europe. He was in Bethabra and he drew a beautiful diagram of a medicinal garden. So we have some of those things that he had plotted on that medicinal garden diagram. Let's go look.
Oh, look, tansies. I love tansies.
Oh. Tansy is beautiful, but in addition to being beautiful, it's very helpful in the garden. It gives off a scent that the harmful insects do not like.
Yes, but the beneficial insects are attracted to the smell, like hoverflies, lady beetles, lacewings. They are all over the garden helping pollinate.
Let's take a closer look at tansy. The structure of tansy is like that of many flowering plants. You have the stem. The stem is what holds the plant upright so that the leaves can reach toward the sun. The stem also contains important parts that help the nutrients and water move from place to place within the plant. Now let's look at the leaf. The leaf is where food is made for the plant through a process called photosynthesis. Also, on the back side of the leaf are tiny little pores or holes that extra water can leave from the plant. This process is called transpiration. Now let's take a look at this beautiful bloom or flower. The flower is very important for the reproduction of the plant. It is what helps the process of pollination and fertilization, where little plant seeds are formed in order to make more plants of the same type.
Don't forget an important part of the plant that we aren't seeing, the roots. We left them in the ground to keep the plant anchored in place. Roots absorb water and minerals for the plant. It's dinner time, little one.
We mentioned beneficial insects that are attracted to tansy and like to be near tansy. Lady beetles, or you may call them lady bugs, are one of those insects.
I love lady beetles. Let's take a closer look at the life cycle of a lady beetle. The lady beetle begins life in an egg, and the eggs are shaped like a yellow football. The mother lady beetle produces clusters of 10 to 50 eggs at a time and attaches them to the underside of a leaf. The leaves of tansy are great nurseries for a mother lady beetle's eggs.
A lady beetle hatches from its eggs in 3 to 5 days. When it hatches, it is called a larva. The larva looks like a very small black alligator with orange spots. This little larva can eat lots of aphids. Aphids are harmful to plants. So this little larva is performing a valuable service to our gardens.
Once the larva has gorged itself on a yummy dinner of insects for 2 to 3 weeks, it becomes time for it to pupate. The process of pupation is actually amazing. Basically, the larva dissolves and reforms into an adult inside a protective sac called a chrysalis.
After 7 to 10 days in a chrysalis, the pupa stage is complete and an adult lady beetle emerges. The adult lady beetle then finds a mate, more eggs are laid, and the cycle starts all over again. Lady beetles can live up to 1 year. As we've looked at the structure of tansy and the life cycle of lady beetles, we see that their basic needs, air, water, food, are all met here in Salem in the mixed family garden.
Yes, that's true. But you know, the tansy and the lady beetles were not original to North Carolina. Mm. They were brought here from Europe. And other things were brought from other places too.
Let's take a look at this basket. It's filled with produce or plants that grow here in Salem now, but did not always grow here.
Oh, let's start with this beauty here.
I'm sure everybody knows about watermelon. It is delicious, but it didn't always grow here in Salem. It originated in Western Africa. And we know that the pharaohs loved watermelon also. We know this because the seeds have been found in their tombs. Now, let's take a look at these. You may not know what these are. I'll give you a hint. Sometimes people get them mixed up with sweet potatoes. These are yams. Yams also originated in Africa. And believe it or not, the largest yam can weigh over 100 pounds.
Look at these. Do you know what these are? These are okra. Okra originated in Ethiopia. Okra can be eaten in several ways. Fried, stewed, used as a thickener, and the seeds can be roasted and made into a coffee-like beverage. Personally, I think I like them fried the best. These are black-eyed peas. They're actually beans. They were domesticated in Africa. Many people believe that if you eat black-eyed peas on New Year's Day, you'll have prosperity in the coming year. I forgot to eat them this year. Sorry.
All of these things came from Africa. When enslaved people were brought to America, some of these things came with them in the form of plants or seeds. The ones that grew well here in North Carolina have become part of our gardens here in Salem. We're going to take a closer look at the life cycle of the black-eyed pea.
I love the black-eyed peas. Let's get it started in here.
It all starts with a seed. After about 10 days, the seed, if it's watered and in soil of the right temperature, will germinate.
Germinate means to sprout.
And the first shoot that comes out of the seed will become the plant's root.
After germination occurs, the seed grows into a seedling. You can see the stem at this stage.
Once the stem grows up a bit, the leaves uncurl to start making food for the new plant.
Now our little baby plant is on its way to becoming a mature plant capable of reproducing. Flowers on plants aid in the reproduction process. Their pretty colors and nice scents attract birds and insects, which help the plant with pollination.
When pollination occurs, fertilization soon follows, and a new seed is formed. And it's a good thing more seeds are formed, because I can eat lots of black-eyed peas.
Me too. Well, we've learned a lot about the life cycle in our garden today. I hope that you all can go visit your gardens and see what kinds of living things are in them.
And I also hope the next time you see a ladybug, or you smell tansy, or you eat okra or watermelon, or even black-eyed peas, you think about those who brought these things with them when they arrived in America.